Good morning, dear students. Today we shall discuss about the essay, prose essay written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar in his book What Congress and M.K. Gandhi Have Done to the Untouchables. This essay is a chapter in the same book I have mentioned, and the title of the essay is Gandhism, the Doom of the Untouchables. Why does Dr. Ambedkar call Gandhism as the doom of the untouchables? Exactly, this is what he has discussed in this prose essay. In this prose essay, he does not consider all the principles of Gandhi's ideology, but he focuses on that part of Gandhism which did not or which failed to bring happiness in the lives of Dalits. He systematically analyzes Gandhi's views on social and economic conditions of the country. This essay is written in 7 parts. The first part is a sort of preface to the whole essay, and Dr. Ambedkar explains how the term Gandhism came into being. There are so many isms, and Gandhism also came into being, but Gandhi himself did not proclaim that there is no such ism by his name. But when people said that Gandhian philosophies together can be called as Gandhism and it is a strong movement, Mahatma Gandhi did not speak anything about it. And later, he writes in the preface, or I mean the first part, why he has chosen to speak on Gandhism, a topic which is very much complex. He says towards the end of part 1 that the untouchables need to be aware of Gandhian beliefs, Gandhian philosophies, and they should not approach it as a complete philosophy because it is creating doom for the untouchables. Now, why does he say that it creates doom for the untouchables? He goes on justifying the ideas of, justifying throughout his essay, and goes on systematically analyzing, critiquing the idea of Mahatma Gandhi related to society and economy, because it is economy and society which has decided the fate of the untouchables. Untouchables, we know the history, they were the victims of social discrimination. They were the victims of economic inequality. And if we have to bring the untouchables to a better level in society, we have to bring them out of these troubles like social discrimination and economic inequality. One more problem that is seen in India is there is no dignity of labor. Which we actually find in the Western world. And in this essay, Ambedkar also speaks of the importance of dignity of labor. Now, since in India, in Indian society, dignity of labor is not there, untouchables are economically deprived and they are humiliated by the society. In America or in the Western societies, no matter what job you do, you are always respected. Your worth as a human being does not reduce by the work or profession you do. There, a sweeper is equal to status of a teacher, right? So there is dignity of labor, everyone is respected as a human being. But unfortunately, in India, there is no dignity of labor, and people decide or judge others by their profession, and they have made a hierarchy of profession. This is the problem for the untouchables who have always remained in the lower strata of the society. This situation is Ambedkar is speaking about is of the pre-independent times. Okay. So, how does Ambedkar attack on Gandhi's ideas in this essay? We will just have a brief discussion about this. Why does he attack on Gandhism? Although Mahatma Gandhi used the word, a better word for the untouchables, as Harijans, his principles actually did not have any practical solution for the problems of the untouchables. Later in the essay, in the beginning part of the essay, Ambedkar has taken the reference of Gandhi's principles written down by Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, in various works. He takes a direct references of them, and later in the second part of the essay, he goes on and criticizing each one of them in a very disciplined and systematic manner, and justifies the title, Why Gandhism is the Doom of the Untouchables. Now, he seems to be opposite to Gandhism because Gandhi believed in the caste system and he believed in the Varna system as well. And this Varna or caste system itself was unhealthy for the growth of untouchables. Due to caste system, some sort of professions were labeled, they were assigned for untouchables, and they could never overcome those professions. They will be lifelong into lowly professions because of caste system. And in fact, Ambedkar believes that Gandhi favored this caste system in order to retain his popularity among the public. Later, he says, even Gandhi misinterpreted the Varna system, whereas the original Varna system judged a person based on his profession. But according to Mahatma Gandhi, in his references, he says, Varna system is also determined by birth. So when this is the problem, no matter however much you try to overcome your difficulties, you shall be always labeled as Harijan or untouchable or a Dalit. Then where is the solution for the problem of the Dalits? This is how Ambedkar speaks about the problem of Varna system and caste system as upheld by Mahatma Gandhi in his principles. And somewhere in part 2 of this essay, Ambedkar also accuses Gandhism of favoring regionalism. Regionalism is, Mahatma Gandhi in his philosophy says that villages should develop, villages should prosper economically. But practically it was not possible because cities which were being industrialized, which were being urbanized, which had the luster of a dignified life, were growing economically very well, and a Dalit or an untouchable had more opportunities in the cities to live a more comfortable and better life than compared to the life in the villages. So Ambedkar does not favor the regionalism done by Mahatma Gandhi, because he feels that only development of villages cannot bring out the untouchables from their problems of social discrimination. Because we see this is the reality. In an urban area, the thoughts of touchability, untouchability are very rarely found. But in villages, the practice of caste system is still followed. So when the people can't come out of their villages, they will always remain in economically lower section, as well as they will be victims of social discrimination. So he is of the opinion that cities should grow, there should be industrialization, wherein people from different parts of the country go and migrate into the cities, where the untouchables can lead a comfortable and better life with the dignity of labor. Further, Ambedkar speaks about the economic perspectives of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi, as we know, in his philosophies, upheld Swadeshi goods, and he did not believe in the machine revolution. In fact, he opposed Gandhism, opposed machinery revolution. Gandhi believed that machines will make people lazy, will make people dependent on others, and thereby reduce the productivity. But Dr. Ambedkar has a different view on machinery revolution. He says machinery revolution will be a solution, a practical solution for the economic problem of the untouchables. Because when you bring machines into the industries, and when more and more machines are used, it can lead to a lot of productivity, which will increase the capital or increase the money for the nation, as well as the machines, when they replace, they help, in fact, the machines help the humans to produce more and more goods, and thereby reducing the human efforts. When the human efforts are reduced, untouchables or the Dalits, who are always a major population among the labor class, will get time of leisure. When they get time of leisure, they can involve themselves in the activities such as education and many other cultural activities as well. So this machine revolution can provide an opportunity for the Dalits to have the time of leisure, in which they can have an access to different parts of different aspects of culture. Thereby, they can overcome the problem of social discrimination. And this leisure will also give them time to educate themselves. When they educate, they can overcome the problem of economic inequality. They can go for the higher kind of higher paid jobs, white collar jobs, and detach themselves from the stigma attached to the to them because of this social discrimination. Later, he goes on giving examples of how violence or protests help laborers to gain more wages in European countries. So he supports that kind of movement. But in fact, Gandhi's principles of peace do not support the concept of violence through which they can get increase in their wage. Somehow, he believes that Gandhi and Gandhi's ideals believed in living a life with minimum satisfaction. Whereas satisfaction in one's life, it may be economic satisfaction or social satisfaction, is a right of everyone, every individual. So to get more wages, to get a higher social status, what is wrong if the untouchables or the labor class people make strikes and make protests? So thereby they can overcome the difficulties in easy way. So there, when Gandhian philosophies oppose machinery revolution, Ambedkar criticizes Gandhism, saying that Gandhism does not have a passion for economic equality, and only through economic equality untouchables can, or the laborers or the Dalits can live a better life. This is what Ambedkar says. Later he also says return to nature, as Gandhi propagated, is not a solution for the modern world, problems of the modern world. He feels that the ideas of Ruskin, Rousseau, which were followed by Mahatma Gandhi, were archaic and old, and they cannot befit the modern social conditions of the untouchables. Further, he says the problems or evils of the modern society are not due to machines, but due to a wrong kind of social organization which was found in the Varna and the caste system in India. Later, Ambedkar accuses that the social ideal of Gandhism is never democracy, but it is either Varna or caste system. Later, towards the end of the essay, where he finds Mahatma Gandhi commenting about the job done by a Brahmin, the job of scavenging. Okay, he seems to appreciate the work done by a Brahmin as a scavenger. If a Brahmin does a scavenging work or cleaning work like sweeping and all, it is appreciated by Gandhi, but this cannot be an ideal solution for the untouchables, because Ambedkar believes that if a Brahmin does the work of scavenging or cleaning or sweeping the floor, his status as a Brahmin will not be reduced. He can still be on the top of social hierarchy. But what about the untouchable? Untouchable who is always labeled for the same kind of work like scavenging and sweeping, if he does other jobs, like if he achieves through his hard work the position of any white collar job, is there going to be a deletion of stigma attached to his caste? So no matter what you do, an untouchable will always remain untouchable if Gandhian principles are followed. So he says glorification of the work or the traditional occupations of untouchables is not a solution for the problems of the untouchables. By only glorifying that or saying that scavenging or cleaning the premises, sweeping the floor is a good work, it's a divine work, it will not bring them out of the stigma attached to them because of the horrible social organization in terms of caste system and Varna system. Thus, he says, Gandhism is a paradox. While Gandhism seeks for freedom from the British rule, it does not seek for the internal freedom from the social structure. It supports the domination of one class over the other class. This is the claim made by Dr. Ambedkar in this essay. Later, he also says that Gandhism is the philosophy of the well-to-do and the leisure class, and it does not offer any solution for the masses. Masses are made of labor class people or the have-nots. Further, he asks a subtle question to Gandhism like this: what is the use of telling the scavenger that even a Brahmin is prepared to do scavenging, when it is clear that according to the Hindu Shastras, even if a Brahmin did scavenging, he would never be subject to the disabilities of one who is a born scavenger? So this is the crux of the problem. Okay, if an untouchable does the work of scavenging, it is his fate according to the caste system. But if a Brahmin does the scavenging work, then it is praised. What is the use of praising the work which is actually not so dignifiable to a human being? Instead, you dignify the people and not the work. So, if a Brahmin does the scavenging work, it will not give any solution to the stigma or the problem attached to the lives of untouchable. So this is how, later in part number 6, he says, Gandhism claims to abolish untouchability, but how far has it been successful in reality? Only by naming untouchables as Shudras or Harijans does not ensure them social equality. So this essay mainly focuses on the practicality of Gandhism in giving the Dalits what they really needed. What they really needed was social and economic equality. Only by showing sympathy to the Dalits, or only by glorifying or calling the works of Dalits like works like scavenging, sweeping as divine works, will not lead to any social equality among the Dalits. Further, he asks certain questions also, like, will Gandhism guarantee the right of untouchables to the education? Has it done anything to give them rights? Apart from sympathizing, Gandhism has not done many things for the untouchables. Will it guarantee education, higher education, or will it ensure a good profession for the untouchables? Gandhism, and the answer logically is no. Will the untouchables be free to make use of their learning and knowledge? Will they have the right to choose their profession? So why is he asking these questions? It is because Gandhism believed in the support of caste system, which did not allow choice for the untouchables to choose their profession. So he asked this question: will Gandhism give opportunity, will it give the right for the untouchables to choose their profession? Can they become lawyers, engineers, doctors? And the answer given by Gandhism apparently is a no. In part number 7, it is like a sort of conclusion. Considering all these aspects, Ambedkar believes that Gandhism is an illusory campaign against untouchability. It will not give any solution, real solution. Just it can give sympathy, but not the real solution to the problem. And he says Gandhism is another form of Sanatanism, that is in support of Orthodox Hinduism. And later he also says there are lots of similarities between Orthodox Hinduism and Gandhism, and he ends the essay with a statement that in Gandhism there is hope only for Hinduism, its caste and varnas, and not for the untouchables. So this is how he has analyzed, Dr. Ambedkar has analyzed Gandhian principles in the context of the problem of the Dalits. For Ambedkar, in this essay, it matters whether Gandhism can give something to the untouchables or not. His other principles like non-cooperation, prayer, non-violence are not considered by Ambedkar in this essay because they were not relevant to the problems of the untouchables. So this is how it is an objective analysis of the text Gandhism, the Doom of the Untouchables. So that's all in this lecture. Thank you so much.